What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. Today we are up here at Brighton Ski Resort, my home and local resort here in Salt Lake City, Utah. And today we're gonna be talking about sequence photos. We're gonna shoot some fun stuff in the park today. We're gonna take some park laps, probably go up through the jumps and then hit some rails as well. But then I'm gonna jump in my computer and we're gonna just go through the process of how stitching it together. Super easy process if you know what you're doing. So yeah, it's gonna be really fun. We're gonna meet up with Scooter, which is my good buddy. Make sure to follow him on Instagram. And yeah, should be a good time. I'm really excited. But without further ado, let's get it. Okay guys, so I just met up with Scooter. We are here at the jumps, as you can see. And basically, here are kind of the rules and how to do this successfully. So obviously you wanna shoot with a high shutter. So any burst mode on any camera works. You can use an iPhone, you can use GoPro, you can use your DSLR, whatever works. Oh. Ooh. So yeah, you can use any DSLR. Pretty much, you just wanna shoot really fast. Second rule is try to keep it as still as possible. So you wanna, like, you know, post up at a, whatever your subject is, just post up and keep your camera like a steady frame, essentially. So this is gonna be our frame that we're gonna be shooting. It's gonna be this jump. So here's the jump that we're gonna be filming on. We're gonna hit it a couple times and then we'll see what we get. We focus. Alright, let's run it back. Let's see what it looks like. Scooter with the sick rodeo. Dope.
You.
Woo! Oh, that was sick, dude. Yeah. Oh, sick. It's so good out here.
Super fun. Okay, so we're gonna go take some park laps. We'll keep shooting, get some more content. But I'm gonna jump onto my computer and we'll stitch all that together. Okay, so now that we are back on the computer, we're here at the desktop. Usually what I'll do is I'll upload them into Lightroom, do all of my editing, throw my whatever presets on them, and then I will export them into a folder. So here I have my folder, Scooter's Photos, and here you can see sequence photos going from 1 all the way up to 17. And we probably won't use all of these photos, but it gives us a lot of options to play around with. Scooter goes up, does that little back rodeo. Looks pretty sick. And we'll probably stop the sequence probably somewhere in this range. We'll start here. This will be our base photo, I'm thinking. So right click, open with, throw it into Photoshop. Okay, sick. So pretty much kind of some important things to think about when you're doing a sequence photo like this is to be conscious of the subject and the size, and then also the shadows, because there's been times where I've done like a sequence photo and I forgot to copy the shadow as well, which is kind of a subtle thing that most people probably wouldn't pick up on if they're looking at your photo. But if you want to just, you know, have the best technique as possible, just make sure you're aware of that as well. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go over here and we're going to see what we want our next photo to be in the sequence. I'm thinking probably this one right here, just because he's still on the jump and he's gonna fit right in this spot pretty nicely. So what I would probably do is I'm gonna open this into Photoshop as well, so it creates its own like separate file or separate tab, and then we'll basically just copy and paste him over into the main background photo that we're working with. And remember, like, this is kind of, there's probably a bunch of different ways to go about doing this, and this is just kind of what I've taught myself. So take it with a grain of salt. Okay, so for this first photo, what we're gonna do is, there's a couple ways we can go about doing this. You can use your lasso tool, which you can use, you know, your three different versions. You can also use the selection tool, which usually is going to be the best option. But for this one specifically, we're just going to use the lasso tool just because you're not really dealing with him overlapping the first photo or anything like that. So we can just make a quick little layer. Remember to get those shadows. Okay, so now that we have this masked, what we're going to do is we're just going to drag and copy it into the other layer. So we just smash that bad boy. Look how good that looks already. So as you can see, it's overlapping our first layer. No problemo. So what we'll do is we'll just get the erase tool and just erase. And an easier way to do this is you can make the opacity. Make sure you're on this layer, the one we just did. But you can bring the opacity down a bit just so you can really see where the board is underneath the helmet. Bada bing, bada boom. Okay, sick. So that's one of two, easy peasy. Now we're gonna go rinse and repeat. We'll just basically find the next image. So that's that one. And just like on this photo, you wanna make sure you're getting all this extra movement of the snow. Pretty much any detail that's in this frame, you wanna add to our sequence just cause it's gonna give you much more information. And this one's gonna be a little bit trickier just cause there's a lot of snow. Luckily we have this lip right here, the jump, so we can line that up and then kind of work from there. Sick. And then again, just grab that erase tool, make sure you're still on this new layer. Usually I'll use this little, it's more of a, I don't know what the word is for the, it's more of a fuzzy erase tool. So then you can kind of go in and use the edge to like soften it up and make it blend really nicely. So we're making our way. It looks pretty solid so far. And then I think one of these are gonna be one of the last frames that we'll use. Let's use that one. Okay. Okay, rad. Well, so that's kind of, there's a nice little sequence photo for you. Here's our layers. I'm going to delete these. So boom, boom, boom. And then there you get to go. I want to do, let's jump into one more that we did that day. This one will be a little bit more detailed and more difficult. So let's do that. Okay, so we're back into Lightroom. Pretty much from here, we're just gonna choose a sequence that looks good. Here's a couple photos that we took that day. It's pretty sick ones, I'd say. This one's pretty good. This one's of me doing a back blunt on this flat tube. So that's a pretty good sequence. Cool. So this gives us a nice little base to start off on. And then let's see what our next one. So we have that probably like right there. That's what we're gonna do, that one right there. And that's the thing, is you wanna find a balance between like too many layers or not enough layers. This one, we're gonna kind of stack it, but for the most part, you wanna just kind of find a balance with those. Grab the snowboard. See, even like right down here, you want all this shadowing stuff. Just because it gives you context in the photo. Because if it's not there, when you put it in there, it's gonna look a little bit off. And the goal of the sequence photo is just to make it so it's like completely right on. And then we'll remember there's this little bump right there that will sync up. And a swing. All right, there's the bump right there. And then we'll get this fuzzy edged eraser and just gradually let it kind of mix in. Cause then it just looks like a shadow on this snowbank. And then we'll kind of clean this up over here. And the more you do this, the better you'll get at it. It kind of takes some time to like know your Photoshop's like tools. Minus these guys. So we started there, boom. Boom, boom. So there's our sequence. Looks pretty dope. Again, we can go flatten image. That's just gonna connect them all together and then crop for Instagram. Instagram is what controls all of us and our cropping abilities. Sick, okay. Well, that is the final product. So we got that one and then we have our first one right here. So here's our two little final products. Super easy technique to do, and I think it's definitely worth knowing this technique if you are going to be in this type of industry of photography. It's just something to add to your, you know, your resume of abilities. So
hope you guys enjoyed this whole kind of snowboarding video. We're gonna be coming out with a few more. I'm gonna do you know, how to edit GoPro video, like snow GoPro video, so you can try to get it as best as you can to look like GoPro's actual videos. So feel free to drop a like on this video, guys, and yeah, keep an eye out for all the others. Make sure to follow me on Instagram, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Thanks so much.
Peace. Just watch me.